Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be talking about duplicate roles within Salesforce and how to set them up. So let's go ahead and jump into setup and we'll get started. All right, from here I'm going to type in duplicate in the quick find and set up a duplicate rule. So we do have a few rules set up. These are going to be standard rules that come with Salesforce, but I want to create a new one. We can choose account, contact, individual, lead, or our custom object named projects. I'm going to go with leads because this one is really familiar to most people. So I'm going to have this be match by phone number, which I believe is something that we can match. We can add a description if we choose to, but it's not required. Again, required information is anything with a red bar next to it. We can choose the record level security to enforce sharing rules or to bypass sharing rules. So if you enforce sharing rules, you may have two of the same leads in the same org, but because people can't see each other, see each other's leads, then they'd be both working the same lead. However, I'm going to bypass sharing rules personally, because in the orgs I've worked on, you don't want to be having multiple people contacting the same person. This might be different for different people or for different orgs and what your security tolerance is. So we have different actions that we can use. We can choose when we can allow for records to be validated through this duplicate rule. We can do the action on create or the action on the edit. I'm going to allow both of these and alert and report as well. So what this means is that it will run on creation of the lead saying, hey, this might be a possible duplicate lead. And then we can also have it be on the edit as well, where it will run and alert and report. Maybe it didn't fire off of the create, but however, on edit, we realize that with more information, this lead might be a duplicate of another in our system. So now we can choose a matching rule. We can create a new matching rule or use another one. I'm going to save this duplicate rule and create a new matching rule. So here we are going to match by the phone. This is going to be the rule by which the matching is occurring, and then it will fire the duplicate rule. So I'm going to go by phone number. Let's do phone. Matching method is exact, or we could choose fuzzy, so it could be 90% correct or something like that, but I want this phone number to be exact. We can choose to match blank fields or to not match blank fields. I'm going to not match because we may have like thousands of leads that just don't have a phone number. So I will click save and I'm going to activate this matching rule. All right, they're going to send me an email. And now going back to the duplicate role, we can look and see if we go back to edit that we have the matching role matched by phone. And then we can choose conditions or we cannot choose conditions by which this record must be met. We could select that let's go ahead and go in that lead converted is equal to false. So it must not be converted for it to be fired. So any leads that are open match by the phone number or to select the phone number may match. I'm going to select save. We do need to activate this. And it is activated. So it will pop up with a possible duplicate if the lead phone numbers match exactly. So that is how you set up a duplicate rule for a lead and a duplicate rule in general. You can use this to, if you have any questions, be sure to drop them down below and I'll be sure to get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you so much for joining me. Check out the courses down below if you'd like to join the email list. You can do that at salesforceemily.com, and I will catch you guys in the next one.